My message today is the same one I commanded the earlier prophets to speak to Jerusalem and its villages when they were prosperous, and all of Judah, including the southern desert and the hill country, was filled with people. So once again, I, the Lord All-Powerful, tell you, see that justice is done, and be kind and merciful to one another. Don't mistreat widows or orphans or foreigners or anyone who is poor, and stop making plans to hurt each other. But everyone who heard those prophets stubbornly refused to obey. Instead, they turned their backs on everything my Spirit had commanded the earlier prophets to preach. So I, the Lord, became angry and said, "You people paid no attention when I called out to you, and now I'll pay no attention when you call out to me. That's why I came with a whirlwind and scattered them among foreign nations, leaving their lovely country empty of people and in ruins." Those words come from Zechariah chapter 7, verses 7 to 14. When God speaks to a nation that is rebelling against Him and has banned prayer and the Bible from the public life of the country, what does He say? There is no doubt that He does not speak warm words of comfort and peace. God speaks words of repentance and warning to a country that has turned from Him. The problem with the United States is not one of leadership. United States citizens elect their leaders and continue to say that godliness is not a qualifying characteristic for men or women who want to be national leaders. The difficulties with the United States are not the result of conservative or liberal fiscal policies. We cannot budget our way out of the consequences of turning our backs on God. The answer for this nation, and by the way, all nations, is Jesus Christ. If a nation turns its collective and individual hearts back to Jesus, and in repentance falls down and worships Him, there will be a revival, not only of the spirit of that nation, but also a revival of everything that made that nation great before their fall. But don't be fooled. Calling out to God for help without first turning to Him in repentance will not work. It is only after real repentance that revival comes. Otherwise, God will pay no attention to us when we call out to Him. Lord Jesus, we have turned our hearts away from You and banned You from the life of our country. May we be about the business of repenting of that national sin today, that we may call out to You for the help that can only come from Almighty God. May that repentance begin with me, as I once again make You, Lord, the most important person in my life. Praise Your holy name forever. Amen.